The other thing we want to talk about, Chris, is the fact we had all that rain and where the temperature is right now.
Right about 32, 33. Guys, this is the problem. As we plunge tonight, we're going to go back through the 20s and eventually to the teens. So a lot of this is going to be freezing over. So, you know, you may have been looking at the rain much of the day. In some areas, still seeing some rain down to the south. But this storm is coming, and I assure you, it is going to deliver a wintry punch. And we're going to be calm and clear about that the next 24 hours. Still going to be experiencing snow. This is just the tip of the iceberg. Total accumulations, 8 to 14 inches. That still puts this in the context of a major winter storm in our area. Slow travel is going to be extremely likely, becoming poor tonight into tomorrow morning. In some areas, potentially even impossible travel with the blowing and drifting late tomorrow. We'll keep you up to date, though, on that free WTL11 weather app. We've got several videos waiting for you. You can go ahead and check them out while we're scrolling through the weather right now. Our Doppler radar, it is indicating that changeover still is yet to happen in Tiffin, Wyandotte, and Crawford County, across Hancock County. Findlay is still looking at rain. Now, earlier I mentioned this. This is kind of interesting. You may be familiar with the Storm Prediction Center. They typically would issue alerts and advisories during the severe weather season. Well, they've actually highlighted a portion of this winter storm that is potentially capable of producing up to 1 inch per hour snowfall rate. So they issued a special discussion across this area, southern Michigan, extreme northwest Ohio, where snowfall rates over the next couple of hours of 1 inch per hour. So do some quick math between now and 8 p.m. That could be about 3 inches of quick snow that's coming down. It is still 41 and raining in Findlay, 41 over toward Upper Sandusky. But look where we've dropped now below freezing. And that's the beauty of being able to see where those temperatures are and where the rain is falling. Still looking at rain in Tiffin and over toward Fremont. This will change over likely in the next 60 to 90 minutes. Now, we still have steady snow. The entire Toledo Metro, will give you a few views. This is one that turned really snowy early today. And this is a view toward US 23, Ohio-Michigan state line. You can even see the medians. They are all snow covered and roads are going to be slushy and slippery. They're going to get even worse tonight. And this is what you want to avoid, an issue toward Airport Highway. We've been able to zoom in on that. There's a couple police cars, slow traffic there. And of course, if you see those emergency vehicles, you're required to be moving over to allow them maximum safety. How about this? A live look across 6 different vantage points and look toward Findlay. It's still actively raining right now in the lower 40s. Back up in the Toledo Metro, we've got snow. We've got snow now in Bowling Green, snow in Waterville, West Toledo, and Perrysburg. Views all across the area. Total accumulations, 8 to 14 inches will be expected. That's tonight into tomorrow. Before it wraps up tomorrow evening, I expect the accumulations will be significant, and those winter storm warnings across our area are going to be widespread. Winter storm warnings across all of Northwest Ohio. In fact, they extend well south and west into Texas. That is nearly 2,000 miles of winter storm warnings that extend from Texas into Maine. Here's the timing of all this. All steady snow tonight. We're going to be falling back into the 20s and even teens. More snow expected overnight into tomorrow morning. Accumulations will continue to mount. An additional 4 to 7 inches of snow tomorrow. And I expect this will taper off. Tomorrow evening, we'll see the last of our snow accumulations. Steady snow tonight, down to 18, 4 to 7 inches of an accumulation. Highs tomorrow, 22 degrees, another 4 to 7 inches of an accumulation. And our extended 10-day forecast does have highs in the teens Friday and Saturday. Could even be below zero Saturday morning. 20s much of next week. And we're fortunate beyond this winter storm, things will be quiet most of our 10-day forecast.